creating a table of contents in InDesign and exporting it in Flipsnack with just two clicks. That's today's challenge, and this video will be your guide. So, first things first, creating your first table of contents isn't all that hard, but it will require a bit of attention. You know, details are the key for everything. Firstly, you will need to make sure each and every single one of your headings is formatted with the same name. How do you do this? InDesign makes it fairly intuitive. Simply click on your heading, go to Window, and click Style. Name this style Heading 1 or whatever name inspires you most. Right, so you've created a style that will serve you as a template for all of your headings. Now, you simply need to select the rest of your headings and apply to them the same style that you just created. You'll see why doing this is so important in a moment. This step will tell InDesign what headings to show in the table of contents. Next, we must create an actual style for our table of contents. This second step will tell InDesign how to show the headings in the table of contents. Again, name the style so that you can recognize it later. Now, all the rules are in motion. Time to create an actual table of contents. Select your desired page, go to Layout, and click Table of Contents. Now you'll see why keeping the same format name for each heading is important, as you only need to add these once. Apply the style you just created to your headings, and you're done. Just make sure to tick one tiny thing, the Make Text Anchor in Source Paragraph setting. It has a long name, but it only requires just one click. Great! Now it's time for the easy part, preparing your InDesign document for export. Some settings will be required for this, but don't even bother with them. We've already taken care of that and prepared a preset that has them stored and ready for you. All you need to do is download and install the Flipsnack preset into your Adobe program of choice. Find the link to download this preset in the description box below. After you've installed the preset, simply go to File, and under Adobe PDF Exports, amongst other options, you will see Flipsnack Export. This export preset will also work on any Adobe app that allows PDF exports. Click the magical button, name your file, and there you have it. By having the preset installed, you can rest assured that you won't ever have to bother with all of those settings over there. But wait, there's more. We've covered the export part, but what if you want to upload your document directly into Flipsnack without having to export it first? We have a plugin prepared for you that allows you to do just that. Be sure to check the link in the description box to find out more about it. You see, that's how easy it is to prepare your PDF to make sure you have a smooth upload process.